I can tell you the Yom Kippur day in Auschwitz, in Birkenau. And then you realize how we had to help each other. That day, my cousin Chaya and I were working in near the crematorium. And we had to dig in the ashes of our kedoshim. My cousin and I decided that we're going to fast. It was a simple decision. We're not going to drink that coffee, so-called coffee in the morning. And the lunch that we get, that soup, we're going to carry it back into the camp. By this time, each one of us had already a cup for the food, which we carried on a string tied around our waist, and we also had a spoon. We were already civilized people. And so that was our decision. The SS found out that we're fasting. So they decided to give us a present. Get up. Run. Lay down. Push-ups. What they didn't. And the dogs after us. And if somebody falls, the dogs bite them. And this went on I don't know how long. And then we are told, go sit down and eat. So we go sit down. Most of the girls start eating. I'm sitting there with my cousin. And I said, I'm not eating. And she says, okay, I won't eat either. Then the other girls say, what's happening to you? Why aren't you eating? My cousin says, she's much younger than I am. She doesn't want to eat, so I can't eat either. So they ask me, what's with you? I says, well, today is Yom Kippur and I'm fasting. And they said, don't you see that God doesn't want us to fast? If he wanted us to fast, he would have given us much better conditions. And I say, well, maybe he wants to see that dafka, that in spite of it, we are still going to fast. So we're fasting. And in the evening when we took that soup back to the camp, it was sour. It was spoiled because it was a very, very hot day in Auschwitz that day of Yom Kippur 1944.